Bring back was fundraising. I feel like I've done more fundraising seminars and breakout sessions than most anybody on the leadership team. Seems to be my, I guess, my expertise. I don't know. Now, you guys may ask what you need to, why you would need to fundraise. Because everything costs money. That's why. Conventions, you think that, you know, since you're not really putting any money out of pocket or anything like that to go to these conventions, it's because you fundraise and it's the chapter's taking care of it. You gotta think there's travel costs, there's hotel costs, there's food costs, there's registration costs, especially when it comes to international convention. Those are very, especially international ones, are very expensive depending on how many members you can take or can afford to take. And the more you fundraise, the more people you will be able to take with you. Raising money for your honors and action projects and your college projects, again, things take money. I don't think we, like this year's college project was the Commit to Complete banners. Those are more expensive than I would have ever imagined. But when you partner with other groups to do things, it's not as expensive, but when you fundraise for things like that, you have it there, so when the time comes to get those things, you are already prepared to pay for it. Because the Honors in Action and College Project are the most important aspects of your five-star plan. Membership recruitment projects, I don't know if we've actually went that route of actually like going overboard with those, but if you have the funds, you could probably do something outrageous on campus, recruiting members. I know we use Club Day and Squad Captain Week a lot for that, but and then the last thing, membership scholarships. I know some chapters can have fundraising enough where they will actually be able to pay the induction fees for certain members who cannot afford them for themselves. So those are just a few things that fundraising can help with. It goes in a cycle. First thing you do is you research. It's like with everything, you gotta research, you gotta know what you're talking about. You gotta know who you're talking to, what you're talking about, plan, and all that good stuff. You want to build rapport with whoever you're trying to get to sponsor you, to allow you to do something at their restaurant or office building or whatever it may be. And you build rapport. It's like you tell it, you make sure that they know who you are, what this chapter, what you're doing, what things the chapter are actually doing in the community and things like that. And then you ask if what they can help you with. And after all of that, after you've done your fundraiser, make sure you let whoever helped you along the way, make sure you give them thanks so that next time when you come back and ask to do something like that again, they already see, you're on a high level with them already. Again, it's doing the homework. Knowing what organizations outside of the school will do what for the, like, charity-wise or fundraiser-wise is very important, because you don't want to get, like, thinking that you're going to do something somewhere and then it comes up and it's completely, like, 180 degrees difference of what you thought you were going to do. You want to work with the school and especially the College Foundation. We work with Rose Landy a lot, especially here in the last 2 or 3 weeks, trying to get something set up. She runs she's the contact person for the foundation. It's very important that she knows what you have in mind. Because there are rules the school has when it comes to things like that. I call this McGrory's point, because this is something that she talks to me all the time about. It's create a written plan of action, including the who, what, when, and where, and a budget. Dr. McGrory likes everything in writing. It helps to plan, so it's like, it's not all oral, and it's not all coming out of your mouth, and then you go back and change a whole bunch of stuff. When you write your plan of action, it's in writing, and if you need to add something else, you can rewrite it, add to it. But it's very important that you know exactly what you're doing. And a budget, if it's something that requires a budget, it would help to have that on there as well. Reach out to alumni in the area and others in your network, especially with a lot of places like restaurants and things like that. They're going to want you to get as many people into their restaurant as possible. So you want to reach out to people like through your social media networks, through your family, your friends, to get them involved to where they'll show up for whatever you're doing, whether it be a car wash or whatever. And you want to get to know the businesses in your community. This, a lot of the smaller ones, small, you think I keep bringing up restaurants because it's something we've done. The smaller restaurants may not be able to give as much or do as much, but the more you go back to them, the more likely they are to help. Again, building rapport is communication beyond asking. You want to let them know what the chapter is all about. You want to let them know it's an honor society. It's for like some of the best dinners on campus. Let them know that it's went from a 1-star to a 5-star. It's whatever the chapter has done to make it look better with prospective sponsors. Again, let them know when something happens good, let them know about it. Listen to what they say to you, because it may give you an idea of if they say something and you catch it, and it may give you something down the line that, like, they mentioned this and maybe we can do this with them. Show off your strong work ethics and dependability. If you set up something to do with, say, a restaurant or another organization, you want to make sure that the group showing up to work or to perform these fundraisers have a strong work ethic, that is there to do what they need to do, and that those people are dependable, that they're going to show up. And then you want to invite the supporters to your chapter events, whether it's meetings, maybe the induction, if it's like someone you're trying to get involved, other events that the chapter might hold, spot cabin week, things along those lines. Asking for support. Now, I know it can be daunting to ask someone you barely know to help fund something you want to do, but I left this first one here because I thought it was funny. Not as scary as Hallmark deadlines. If anybody, especially us officers, know that when deadlines show up, especially with Hallmarks, that's frightening, because if you don't have this stuff turned in, you're just out of luck. Cash and in-kind contributions can bolster your chapter's projects. In kind, as I put up there, is just stuff that's not necessarily just money, where they provide, say if you're doing something with food on campus, they provide the plates or the napkins or something along those lines can help out. And when you're asking for support, be as specific as possible. Tell them what you're fundraising for, be as specific as possible. Say if it's for next year's regional, Tennessee regional, make sure you tell them that's what it's for. And be sure not to overpromise. Do not tell these people you're talking to that you're going to do something that in the back of your mind you know that's not possible. Even though it's something they may want to hear, if you can't handle it, don't promise it. And again, you want to show gratitude to whoever helps you. Handwritten notes. I think getting like the thank you notes that everybody has, you just sign it and send it to them. I think it would be anything you can do to show that these people that you're grateful that they helped, whether it be administrators, community leaders, participants on site, volunteers, or donors. Anytime you thank somebody for something, they'll remember that. And you want to report back to stakeholders on your project, let people know how it went, whether it was success or failure. Here's some tools you can use. Using the internet for brainstorming, if you put like fundraising ideas in Google, it'll bring up like 1,000 different pages of stuff you can do. The Sign Up Genius and the Volunteer Spot, I had to look them up. They're planning sites that help you organize your fundraiser by like volunteers and when, where, things like that. Social media posts, we have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff. Use those to boost the visibility, get it as far out there. And I know Ron's gonna do that. I'm just about fitted in. Crowdfunding, the GoFundMe thing. Hopefully by the time we get back from Catalyst, we'll have our GoFundMe page up and running. And don't forget to use Phi Theta Kappa's headquarters staff. They have people down there who know all about stuff. This PowerPoint, most of it comes from headquarters itself. So they know all about fundraising. And I'm done.